Welcome to Communication Engineering Playlist. Here in this session, I'll be explaining PLL FM Demodulator. So basically, this is the basic block diagram of PLL FM Demodulator, where here we are able to give FM modulated signal. So here we'll be having FM modulated signal at input side, and that will be given to phase detector. Now phase detector is having two inputs. One input of phase detector, that is FM modulated signal, and second is output of VCO, and its frequency, if I say that is F0, then phase detector circuit, that is what somewhat similar to multiplier. So here you will be getting output of phase detector, that will be Fin minus F0 and Fin plus F0. Now as we know, see, FM modulated signal, that will be combination of carrier signal and modulating signal, where carrier signal's frequency, that is getting changed with respect to modulating signal. So this Fin is having frequency that will be carrier plus deviation. So that deviation is based on modulating signal. So here, when this voltage control oscillator signal, that is generating F0 frequency, so here you will be having two components. One is lower frequency component, that is Fin minus F0, and second is higher frequency component, that is Fin plus F0, where here VCO, that is what controlled at carrier signal. So this is what we are controlling at carrier signal, controlled at carrier. So as this VCO is controlled at carrier, this two frequency component, where lower frequency component will be having information that is related modulating signal. So when you pass this signal through low pass filter, you will be getting Fin minus F0 frequency component over here, and when you amplify that, that will be resulting into modulating signal. So this is how we do demodulation. Like, see, VCO, that is controlled at carrier, that generated frequency is actually given to phase detector. Output of phase detector is equals to the frequency output of phase detector, that will be similar to that multiplier. So it will be generating two components. One is Fin minus F0 and second is Fin plus F0. And when you pass it through low pass filter, you will be getting lower component of frequency that is having modulating signal, which is what Fin minus F0. So at output of low pass filter, you will be getting Fin minus F0. And here, if you see the basic understanding, then this VCO, that is controlled at carrier signal's frequency. So let us see what are the basics which is there with this. Output frequency of VCO is equal to frequency of unmodulated carrier. So it is focused at carrier. The phase detector generates voltage proportional to difference in between FM signal and VCO output. So it is actually giving two components, Fin minus F0 and Fin plus F0. But after passing through low pass filter, you will be getting Fin minus F0. So we are focusing on that difference. Then the output of phase detector passes through low pass filter and amplifier. Here, frequency correction is not required at VCO, as it is done at transmitter section. So here we don't need frequency correction at VCO, but see, as here phase lock loop is there, phase of this signal is properly controlled. So here this VCO is controlled at carrier and phase is synchronized by this VCO. So phase is synchronized by this VCO with carrier, and to extract modulating signal, we just take difference of frequency component of carrier and input FM modulated signal, and that is how we extract original information. So this is all about PLL FM demodulator circuit, and let us sum up this session with few advantages. Here in this circuit we don't need any tuned circuit. It is simple circuit that can be implemented in integrated circuit. So these are the few advantages which is there with PLL FM demodulator. One can see complete understanding of phase lock loop that I have explained with separate session. So just go through that session, so it will be easier to understand once you see that session, and here you can easily understand how things are happening. Thank you so much for watching this video.